the home. A place of love, a place of joy, a place where families live and spend quality time together. A home is the object of countless hours of devoted work to make it someone's own personal utopia. As the saying goes, there's no place like home. But there are certain aspects of a house that often go overlooked. One of these things being the everyday houseplant. And for a houseplant, life is very different.
I remember the old days. Things were different back then.
They're very different indeed. I've led a pretty interesting life. I remember when it all began.
I was born in a nursery of a Lowe's home improvement store in Hillsborough, New Jersey.
Winter of 2001. Shortly afterwards, my mother was potted and sold
to a businessman.
She was forced to live her life in a dreary office with little water and...
even less love.
It makes me shudder just to think about it. As a sprout, I often found myself very lonely, with no one to care for me. And I was constantly surrounded by bigger, meaner plants. It seemed that there was absolutely no hope.
And then, one day,
I hit it off very well with my new owner, Tom. It was a match made in heaven. We were the best of friends, and we did everything together. He did, however, have a dog that I really wasn't too fond of. He was one of those big, slobbery basset hounds, this big, fat body. Long, droopy ears and this large, sniffling nose, and a big, dripping tongue accompanied by this horrifying set of dagger-like teeth that always looked like they just wanted to take this huge bite out of me.
I was scared shitless of that dog. But Tom was always there to protect me and to make sure that I was never harmed. It was a beautiful life we lived. We loved each other very much. We became like brothers. And then, the fall came, and Tom went back to school and, we met a girl.
And before long, we were spending less and less and less time together. It even got to the point where he would often forget to water me. I was getting very depressed.
Not only that, but I could constantly feel that evil stare of the dog peering at me from behind the door of the room he was kept in. And I knew that if that dog ever got a hold of this piece of vegetation, carnage would ensue.
One day Tom forgot to close those doors. And the dog seized the opportunity and went straight for me. And in one great leap, he tore one of my leaves right off.
I guess you could say that this was my breaking point. I began to experiment with various types of drugs and alcohol. I had a particular penchant for Jack Daniels. Sometimes it got a little ugly. 'Cause you know your crown won't
I would also, oh God, how do I put this? It's kind of embarrassing. I would frequent the local brothel where I would engage in raunchy sex with all the plant whores.
Of course, all the sex was unprotected, and I had a short bout with syphilis, but yeah, I would rather not go into that. So along with all the drugs and sex, naturally came rock and roll. I met a few cactus punks through my coke dealer. They had a band, but they needed a singer, so I joined.
We kicked ass. One day, we played a particularly great show, and the after party was equally as wild. So at the end of the night, I was extremely drunk, and I was high on various drugs and other intoxicants. I had snorted some wasabi on a dare. That was pretty weird. Anyway, for some reason, I decided to walk home. And when confronted by a police officer about my state of inebriation, I proceeded to urinate all over him. I didn't even know that I had the ability to urinate.
That's how messed up I was.
I was arrested. I was given a pretty hefty fine.
I'd finally done it. I had hit rock bottom, and I could not go down this path any longer. So I vowed to change my ways, and I truly, truly cleaned myself up. I had quit the band, and with it, the accompanying destructive lifestyle. I was clean, but I was still lonely.
Well, sometimes life plays out in funny ways. See, Tom woke up one morning to find that his girlfriend was gone, along with all the silverware and an egg beater. I don't even want to know. Meanwhile, Tom and I began to rediscover each other. We began to spend time together again, reliving all the good old days where the only thing in our minds was having fun, and have fun we did. We became like brothers once again, and we both enjoyed every minute of it.
Today, things are pretty much the same. Sure, we have our ups and downs, but Tom never forgets to water me, and I never forget to be loyal and affectionate and let him know that I really do appreciate his efforts.
It's been an interesting life I've lived. But it's only made me a better plant, and I'd certainly call it a happy ending. And after going through so much, after experiencing so many different things in my life, both good and bad, it was nice to know that love could still prevail as the ultimate addiction.